So, you've gone to all the trouble of organizing your tasks, attaching resources to them, putting together work breakdown structures and everything, and all of a sudden you want to show off your work to your team or to your boss, and your print preview looks like this. A relatively short project, but spread out over somewhere between 10 to 12 pages. Most of the Gantt chart missing, very, very ugly. What do you do? Would you prefer it if it looked something closer to this? Well, in this video, we're going to show you how that this can be done. Being in a situation like this can be frustrating, but it's not uncommon. But there's a few things that you can do to essentially simplify and get your printed Gantt chart schedules in a manner that is easy for your boss or your audience to digest. And the few things we're going to do today is by revisiting our timescales, perhaps also looking at some of the columns and some of the project information that may be unnecessary for our chosen audience, and then we'll do a little bit of a deep dive into our page setups. So first of all, let's just have a look at some of our visuals, including our timescales and overall bar charts as well. Now you'll recall that in our displaying our schedule video, there's a simple and easy way to tidy up unwanted information on the Gantt chart. And you simply right-click on the Gantt chart itself and go bar styles. And in this particular case, we're going to remove the text relating to resource names because some might find it a little frustrating. And particularly if you're going to go and print this, you don't want all sorts of unnecessary information distracting your audience from the key messages. So click OK, and that piece of unwanted information is removed. So what about timescales? How can we adjust this? Well, the timescale is this section of our Gantt chart up here. You can see there's a fair bit of information there. Probably not the simplest, and certainly the timescales are dragged out over quite lengthy periods, given the short time frame of this project. So we might also look at simplifying this a little further. So how do we do this? Well, right-click like so, and you'll see presented with a few options. We're going to select Timescale, and you'll be presented with a timescale box. Now, we might be comfortable in showing just the one tier. We're going to have one middle tier here. And instead of showing weeks, we might just narrow it down to months to really simplify the overall look and feel of our Gantt chart. And if we click OK, notice how our timescale changes, and also the Gantt chart visuals itself has shrunken to just display an easier time frame for us to follow our project. Now, depending on the length of your project, if it goes over several years, you might consider quarters. You might, if it's smaller projects, you may consider a timescale of weeks or even days. It's really up to you. But for a project like this, around that 4 to 6 month mark, I'd be comfortable in just using months as the timescale. Let's see how our print preview is now. And we can see there's not a great deal of change here. So what else can we do? Well, notice that there's a lot of columns shown here, and depending on our audience, we might consider perhaps making some adjustments to these columns. For example, our boss might not be all that interested in seeing these predecessors here, and also duration. Duration can also be derived from a start and finish date. So let's look at maybe condensing the information shown here. And we can simply do this by moving our vertical line, which divides our worksheet and the Gantt chart across. And if we want to remove a certain column, simply go hide column. Now, we're not deleting the column, it's simply being hidden. For example, if we wanted to get that back again, we could simply go insert column. And you could look for duration, and it returns like so. But for this particular exercise, we might hide this column so that we only display the essential information. We might also consider shrinking these sorts of columns here. How does our new print look now? Well, marginal improvement. but there's still a lot of work to be done. For example, how are we going to show the majority of the Gantt chart here when really it's still spread out over 6 pages? So it's an improvement from the 12 pages before, but how can we fix this? So what further options can we do to try and minimize the amount of pages that are required for this project? Well, let's have a look at our settings. Instead of print entire project, let's select print specific dates. And even though our first date is on the 6th of June here, let's just do a bit of trial and error and start from the 7th and see what that does. Notice that shifts it along a little further. So less wasted space, and we're moving in the right direction. Now you'll notice that our legend here takes up a lot of space on this relatively small page. So what can we do about this? Well, let's just jump into page setup. And you'll be presented with a little box here, page setup Gantt chart. Let's click on the tab legend. And you'll notice here, you can have a legend on every page. I have it on a legend page, effectively your front page, or none. Now, given the fact that we want to utilize an A4 sheet for this particular project, we might elect to go none, and we might also feel comfortable with that, given that our audience may already be comfortable with the look and feel of Gantt chart. So if we select none, now we're heading in the right direction. We've got a lot less wasted space, and we can start to visualize our Gantt chart on the one page. But you'll notice still we are spread out over 2 pages. So is there anything else that we can do to fix this problem? Well, once again, go back into page setup, and we can make some adjustments to our margins. So 1.27 centimeters. We might feel that we can perhaps reduce this. Let's reduce it down to 0.8 each. And there we go, we're getting a little bit more space back on our A4 page. Is there anything else? Is there any more tricks that we can use to try and alleviate this problem? Well, there is one more trick that we'll utilize today, and that is in our page setup. And we click on the page tab, and you'll notice there's scaling. Scale to 100%. Once again, this can be a little bit of a trial and error, so let's reduce this down to say 90 and see what we're left with. Rightio, getting a bit more of our Gantt chart back. Let's maybe move it down to 80% and see how we go. So you'll notice that after doing this, we are getting much, much closer. In fact, over the 2 pages, we need to find enough space to allow this content to fit on the one page here. So there's a couple more things that we can do to try and bring this about. For example, notice there's some wasted lines here. Could we remove these lines? And also, could we shift the task name column over, as we have a little bit of room down on this side of the Gantt chart here, to avoid any double spaced lines in the task name? So let's see how we go by doing this. So by returning back to the Gantt chart, we can simply remove wasted lines here. And then let's see how we go by moving this ever so slightly, avoid any task names that take up 2 lines on the worksheet. Now let's see the result. Print preview page, that has done the trick. You can see that we now have everything on the one page, on an A4 page, no less. Now, of course, if your project is larger, you may consider looking at an A3, but if you don't have an A3 printer, there are little tricks, as we've seen today, to try and bring this back in line with what you want. And notice we still have a little bit of space down the bottom. So let's see what we can do to effectively claw a bit of that back and make it a bit more useful. So we have, remember, at our page scaling to 80%, we put that out now to 85. Let's see what effect that has. There we go. Our audience don't have to strain their eyes too much by improving that, and we've got it all on the one page. So you can see by using your timescales, using your page setups, And tweaking your columns, either by removing them or shifting the width, there's a lot you can do to make your printing a success. All the very best in your scheduling and project management. We hope you found this interesting. Please subscribe and please leave a comment. We'd love to hear from you.